Christian Doige, you are the SPFL Premiership Player of the Month for November. Congratulations, that must really be something to take pride in.
Yeah, great feeling. Obviously, there's some fantastic players in this league, and to come out as the Player of the Month is an amazing feeling, and yeah, really proud.
You were surprised to hear that you have to go back as far as 2013 to find the last Hibs player to win this in the top flight.
Yeah, that's obviously a great thing to hear. Quite surprisingly, really, because we've all the good players that have played for Hibs. But it's a huge honour to win it on behalf of Hibs.
This is the point where you take all the credit for the last month.
Well, I don't know about that, but obviously scored a few goals. Got helped out a hell of a lot by the boys behind me, and hopefully there's many more goals to come.
It's been a consistent theme for Hibs TV interviews over the last few months. Boys have lined up week to week to talk about the selfless shift that you've been putting in, the hard work you've done for the team. So on a personal note, it must be rewarding that you've got something to show for it at the end of that.
Yeah, definitely. And obviously the spell where I didn't score, obviously I was working as hard as I could, and I was just waiting for that little bit of luck, and I think that first goal at St Johnstone really helped me to kick on and give me a bit of confidence going for the rest of the month, and hopefully I can kick on that. Obviously the work rate and stuff, that's first of all what I'm going to do, but hopefully the goals will come quickly.
I know you guys look into the analysis side of things with Calvin and Graham on a daily basis, but I think I'm right in saying that your numbers haven't changed much now from earlier in the season. You're not actually doing that much different.
Yeah, I think it just shows that it's, as a centre forward, sometimes they go in and sometimes they don't. I've obviously put myself in the right positions all season, and hopefully I can do that for the rest of the season. I never go into a game thinking I'm not going to score, and obviously I'm getting myself in good positions at the moment because I'm getting a lot of chances, so hopefully I can do that for the rest of the year.
In a way, you have been judged in the last month because you've scored a lot of goals, but at the start of the season when you were being judged on maybe a lack of goals, you were doing a very different job for the team. Obviously you've played maybe two different roles this term already.
Yeah, obviously it's a lot different with what formation you play. Obviously we played a lot one up front, and you can be isolated up there, and you do a lot of work that probably doesn't get seen. But obviously we've got a new system at the moment, and it's working well for the team. Me and Flo up front seem to work off each other quite well with Scotty in behind, so it's been working well, and hopefully it'll continue to do that.
Yeah, you better say something nice about Flo, because don't want him feeling left out.
No, of course. Flo's been brilliant since we've started playing up front together, and I think we complement each other really well, and yeah.
What is it that you think complements each other well? You do seem to dovetail pretty well together.
Yeah, obviously he's a very good footballer, first of all, and he gets himself in good positions, and he likes to drift out wide, and I'm one of those players who likes to stay in the box and just being around the 6 yard box, and he does a lot of the fancy work, and then on the other end I'm the guy who likes to win the headers and try and bring other people into play, so I think in that sense we work really well together.
When you weren't scoring and now you are scoring, you didn't really seem any different on a day-to-day basis. Where does that come from, or was it a good bit of advice a few years ago, or where does that come from?
I think it's just coming from spells where I've had it before in my career, and if you speak to any striker, they go through spells where they don't score, but I think it happened a couple of times before a scrum where I go a couple of games without a goal, and then one just goes in and you go on a little bit of a run, and I was just waiting for that one to go in, and obviously I went on a run for November, and it's just the way it is as a centre forward. You take some abuse for when you don't score, but then obviously it's all good when you do score those goals.
Well, coming off the back of albeit defeat to Celtic, but it's been a very positive run of late. The supporters are engaged. We've got some big games coming up. Good spell.
Yeah, it's really exciting. Obviously disappointing to lose last night, but they're a great side, and it's a very difficult place to go and get a result. But we were disappointed with obviously losing the game, but we got a great opportunity home against Rangers on Friday, which is really exciting for all the players, and I'm sure the fans are really excited for that one too. And then obviously we got the derby on Boxing Day that everyone's really excited for.
What have you heard about that? What are you looking forward to?
Well, I didn't play too much in the last game. I think I come on for the last 5 minutes, but it was a great occasion. Obviously disappointing to lose the game, so we definitely owe them one at their place, and it's a game that, yeah, really looking forward to. Everyone loves the games around Christmas, and especially when you're playing in a local derby.